See that Existential Bread checked in, but he's not here on Fight Cade. Well, if he's not here, I guess I'll play Flenju, and if he doesn't show up, we'll just call this off, do it another time. Okay, he says he'll be 10 minutes, so I'll just play now. Yeah, I was thinking of doing first of three for like the tournament. Right, that works. Oh, nice throw. That was an interesting combo. Oh, I'm dead. There we go. Oh, that's rough. Got me knocked out. go, looking good. Hoagie in this game is just kind of ridiculous. Alright, Hager coming out. Ooh. Nice. Oh, nice. Actually mistimed my meteor there. Oh, nice. Ah, oh, I missed that tech. Oh. Oh, nice. Oh. Oh, this is really close. Yo, your collect's essential, Brad. There's only a three of us, so we're just gonna do round robin. Oh, that was a bad trade. Just super close games. Ooh, alright. Yeah, we're just gonna be playing first to threes, so report that as 3-2. And then you two can play. Alright, existential bread. I'm gonna see if that works. In the meantime, let me spectate this and then I can get that in. Alright, I put you in the bracket. Oh, damn. Wow, it's a quick one for existential bread. But yeah, at Alright, let's see what we got here. Oh, nice super. Alright, knocked down in the corner. Front this time. Oh, stunned. Okay, that was kind of nonsense. As they both grabbed each other at the same time. Oh wait, we got the El Stingray coming on. Oh. Yeah, Arteaga's damage is rough if you don't really know your way around Stingray. Not to insult, it's just like you know, it's very scary to fight against him. Ooh. Right, quick three-piece. Right, getting tricky with the wall dive. You've just got to be willing to try everything as Stingray, and that means doing a stomp, doing a lot of his running attacks. Oh. Alright, that was a good response. Oh, that... God, Arteaga runs so fast. Oh, opportunity. Oh, no. It's rough. Right, 3-0 existential bread. Okay, so otherwise we're kinda waiting on East Coast here. Okay, there he is. Let me fix that real quick. I could play versus East Coast. Alright, let's go. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Keep it simple with the jabs. Oh, it's not how I punish that. Oh, that was a dangerous cross-up. Oh, yep, got a little too eager to tech there. Was close. Yeah, for a second there that you can't like summon both monkeys, you have to do one at a time. Alright, decision. The Black Widow. That was good timing that threw off my timing to tech a little bit. Take it. Was close, I could have got clipped by that fireball. That's a good trade for me. Oh yeah, that move on rage. Gotta be careful here. Oh. That was tricky. Alright, those were some nice close games. Let me report that. It's three existential bread east ghost. Let's see, do I still have to play? Oh, I have to play existential bread. I'll play him. And after that, I can sit back and actually commentate the other games. Alright, let's see it. Oh. Oh. Oh, damn. This character keeps you locked down so effectively. So mad that whiffed. Oh, right, that niche anti-air works out. I was actually going for the chip, but that works. Oh, that's dead. Yep. I'm gonna try this out. Oh yeah, don't know what I could have done there. Oh, that's keep doing that too early. Ah, it's rough. Thank you. is trying to dash back there. Ah, should have got that. Oh. Ah, I tried to do my reversal there. Nice. Okay, so that's 3-0. Okay, who's up? I guess East Coast versus Flinju. And the last one is going to be Existential Bread versus East Coast. Alright, this is an interesting parallel to make. You got like the fastest character versus the slowest. Jumbo is a weird one. You can lay on the damage, he's got pretty good range. It's just kind of a lack of combo game and relative unsafety of some of his options that can kind of hurt in the long run, but I think it serves pretty well to exchange hits with Stingray. Oh, the stun. Nice. Nice ender. Oh, good headbutt. Oh. Alright, nice combos coming out from Stingray. Yeah, he's just so awkward, you know? Yeah, like, pretty sure that fire spray has a dead zone near him. I think in general, Stingray's slide might give him some trouble, his dashing heavy kick. Oh, gets caught by the slide. Yeah, I guess the issue here is like you can get your movement checked by Jumbo. He actually does a decent job of that. Oh. Yeah, from the right distance that move's pretty good. I think just like how long or short block stun lasts is something you gotta get used to for hitting those running normal punishes. Like, it's something I do as Rasta a lot, is I'll punish something with a running light punch because it's like 2-3 frame startup, I forget. And it knocks down. Oh, yeah. See, right there, he tried to do like crouching light kick into crouching heavy punch as Jumbo, and that didn't connect. Jimbo's crouching HP is a pretty dedicated anti-air. Alright, this is looking a lot better. I think another thing Jumbo might have some trouble with is Stingray's little stomp. I think it's on down and light kick in the air. Kind of the Chun-Li stomp. Be a kind of annoying move. Ooh. Oh, the two hit. Oh, anti-air with the spit. I forgot to update the score. Alright, this isn't looking bad. Oh, gotta be careful about that headbutt. Ah. Oh. And there's a punish. What a weird character in this game. Oh. Alright, Stingray in the corner right now. Oh. Alright, still alive. Nice. Good place to use a slide. East Coast switching to Oni, that's a good pick. I think like regardless of what happens, it's gonna be a fun watch. Right, the hair whip. Yeah, like you look at Oni's hair whip and that move is kinda just a stronger version of the fire breath that the Jumbo has. Characters don't have too much in common otherwise, but you just kind of like, I don't know. Right? They're really going back and forth though. Oh. Yeah, you gotta look out for Stingray's short grab range. I think what Dino used to go for a lot was like, crouching light kick, close heavy kick into Screwdriver. Right, we've got Sei and Bu on. Oh. Likely he got hit by the Phantom Low there. Oh my god, that was an actual combo into it. Oh god. Yeah, Oni just doing his thing. Ooh, the Wraith pick. This is great, we're seeing people just play every character, more or less. Sure, at some point we'll see a top tier Rip Saber come out. No. Rave's got some pretty long normals and good damage, so this might be a funny matchup. Ooh, nice skull. Alright. Just kind of feeling each other out. Good block on the smoke. Oh, that's a super. It's a lot of damage. Wake up, Skull does it. Oh, skull works out. Oh, the angle on that Tatsu is really tricky. Alright. Aw, that's rough. Alright. We'll see if this is round point for East Ghost or not. Ooh. Yeah, when you get it put into a hold, you gotta mash out. This was one of Capcom's first games after Super Turbo, so it's still very much a threat. Oh, the full running grab. Oh, catches him running away. Oh, crouching heavy punch takes it. So we're 2-2 right now. This is great. Ooh. Greater pick? This is a new one. Ooh. Oh, that actually, it's a rare you see that move combo. Ooh, trading with the spikes. Oh, ouch. Probably expecting a throw to tech there, gets clipped by the snakes. No punish from there. Oh, that was a well-placed sweep. Oh, that's it. Alright. 2-2, one round each. You gotta make this one count. Oh. Zhu actually gets a grab. Oh, nice cross up. Oh, jumps clean over the spikes. Oh, this is dangerous. Ah, seals it with a super throw. Well, what an excellent set all around. I think we saw like 5 unique characters that set, pretty much. You know, a new character every game. East Ghost take that 3-2. So East Ghost is existential bread. Let me just report that score. There we go. Alright, this is the last one of the tournament. They were playing like SNES Fighters. They were playing Dankuga earlier. I realized my mic was muted, but thanks everyone for coming out. It was fun.